The great tragedy of Canada, if you ask anyone in the oil patch, is that the country's oil and gas riches lie tantalizingly close, in global terms, to the lucrative, energy-hungry Asia-Pacific markets. If only this country could get its act together to build the necessary infrastructure. Of course, that view is not shared by all Canadians. Getting the oil and gas produced in Western Canada to market has been a long-standing struggle, with the energy sector and the prairie provinces frequently butting heads over pipeline projects with neighboring governments and environmental groups. Along the way, there have been some fossil fuel casualties. Here are the three notable projects that died on the drawing board. Number one, the Enbridge Northern Gateway Pipeline. This would have carried crude from Alberta to tankers at a port in Kitimat, BC, and was greenlit by Stephen Harper's Conservative government in 2014 and then struck down by a federal court of appeal ruling 2 years later. The 525,000 barrel per day project was also subsequently rejected by Justin Trudeau's government. Number two, TC Energy's ill-fated Energy East pipeline. This would have carried more than 1 million barrels of crude oil per day from Alberta and Saskatchewan to coastal refineries in New Brunswick had it been built. The project faced significant pushback from Quebec and Ontario, and a complex and onerous regulatory review that prompted TC Energy to walk away in 2017. Number three, Keystone XL. The possibility of resurrecting this controversial cross-border pipeline came up during the 2024 U.S. presidential debates in September. The pipeline would have carried 830,000 barrels of oil per day from Alberta to the Gulf Coast, but the project endured years of delays amid opposition from U.S. landowners, indigenous groups, and environmentalists. Alberta tried to push the project forward with a $1.3 billion investment in 2020, but the province lost its money when the project was killed by U.S. President Joe Biden upon taking office in 2021.